I had heard rumors that there are two seasons here. There's winter and road repair. So it's been about a year since I wrapped on Happening, and I've been traveling the country doing screenings with the movie. And it's allowed me to go to a lot of interesting places and in Minnesota. Clearly, they're doing something right. When you think of Minnesota, you don't think of sunshine all that much, right? And yet, they're killing it with solar. And they're putting out just massive amounts of wind power. They set a renewable energy standard a decade ago to get to 25% by 2025. They got there 7 years early. Yes, my name is James Redford. I'm with the Redford Center to talk to the governor. And I figured I should take up the chance to talk to the governor and see what he has to say about it. So we're gonna hit the mansion. I have done a little bit of a dive into Minnesota's renewable energy landscape, and you guys are rocking. What's going on? Why aren't you guys bragging?
Minnesota modesty, I guess. But yeah, we've had cooperation with utilities as well as legislators on both sides of the aisle. 20 years ago, you wouldn't have had been able to mention wind energy without being scorned, but everybody's, you know, seen the advantage of it. I mean, wind energy is cheaper than coal-fired, so, I mean, you know, the economics now are in our favor as well.
And when we're spending about $18 billion every year to bring in fossil fuels, that's when you start looking at the numbers, and really creating a new homegrown energy source makes sense.
We're still going to abide by the Paris Accords. We're still going to, you know, keep this commitment. We'll take it, do it on our own initiative. We believe in this, and we know it's the right thing to do, and we're going to do it regardless of the politics in Washington.
The governor has really been a leader in this area, and that
she works for me. She has to say that.
But it's also true.
So I'm here to talk to a professor at University of Minnesota. There's this kind of, you know, sister city type relationship between small cities in Minnesota and cities in Germany that are all interested in ramping up their clean energy. So I'm gonna see what that's about.
And being a good person here means you don't overpromise.
Mm-hmm. Mm.
You underpromise, you overperform.
Mm. It's the opposite in California.
I don't know, you know. As you can hear, I'm not originally from the United States. I'm an immigrant. I come from Germany. The energy footprint in Germany is 1/5 of the person in Minnesota.
1/5?
Yes, right now, today. 36% of the electricity comes from renewable energy.
Welcome, everybody. Some of you know me much better than others, but that is going to change by the end of the week that we spent in Germany. We will know each other so very well by the end of that week. First of all, I'm Sabina Engel. I am the Director of International Partnerships.
I'm Paul Anderson, State Senator from Plymouth.
My name is Kevin Papp. I'm a corn and soybean farmer.
The rural areas, they are profiting tremendously from this transition.
People in Minnesota, they were inspired. We want something like that. How do we make that happen? We have a fabulous group of 5 cities, and they are very different communities. The city of Warren, this 1,500 people ag community, they did a drone program to survey their entire community and to find out, you know, where are the leaks? Where is the heat escaping? Let's make this available to the community, because people really would like to know. It's a conservative community, but it doesn't matter what party you vote for. Energy costs money, and if I can use that money for something else instead of energy, that would be good. The 5 cities are on their way to demonstrate that any community, any size, can move on this path along to being more sustainable.
I'm Larry Herky, and I'm the Director of the Office of Enterprise Sustainability for the state of Minnesota. Hey, Jamie.
Yes, Larry.
Welcome to Minnesota.
So how did you end up getting involved in sustainability, particularly energy efficiency and clean energy usage?
Well, it came down to paying electric bills. I was short about $1 million each year for my electric bills, and I had to find a way to be able to balance the books without having to go back to Washington, D.C. every year by implementing some fairly low-cost initiatives. Usually you can get about a 30% reduction in energy costs within a facility.
And you didn't have to go to D.C. and beg.
I didn't.
That's
yes,
awesome.
It was very good.
Hi, I'm Lieutenant Colonel Larry Herky. I'm here in Camp Adder, Iraq.
Were there any aspects of your military service that made sustainability or renewable energy more meaningful to you?
We were responsible in 2005 through 2007 for moving food and fuel throughout Iraq. As I had a person in front of me, a driver actually died, but we had many soldiers that died too, also defending those convoys. So it seemed to me somewhat senseless. Here we are producing this energy somewhere else, and we should try to make energy as close as we can to where we consume it, and I think that's probably the direction that we should go going forward.
There's a group over at a Pentecostal church in North Minneapolis that's doing something really interesting, so I'm gonna see what's shaking there. You've got some interesting things going on with renewable energy, don't you?
We do. We've had our share of tragedies with deaths, funerals, drive-by shootings, but this phenomenon has been taken a different twist for our ministry to be a part of a community celebration, to provide something of hope for the future by using God's power in order to bring light bills and gas bills down to a bare minimum.
Yeah, that's beautiful.
You can get the same savings from solar power without it being on your roof. So we have people sign up and a lot of what's going on with utilities in general is that it has been a monopoly. Yeah. And we haven't been given a choice in how our energy is produced and or used.
Yeah, this is a 180 kilowatt system, 630 panels. It does require for you to sweat and be able to endure physically as a result of being able to move 73-pound panels. At the end of the day, you'll probably get 10% body muscle and about 10% body fat burnt. So sexy.
So in other words, you're not worried about working out at all.
Man, you don't need any fitness. It's been a win-win for the community, win-win for solar. It's been an awesome thing.
We're just at a starting point, putting jobs and the money back in our local economy and our state, and giving the solar energy benefits to everybody.
You know, I go around the country, and the thing you hear from advocates and people that are clamoring for renewable energy is they say it's going to take everybody. So you know what my takeaway about Minnesota is? That everybody's in.